Hey, what's up? I'm Myles.
And I'm not Shirin.
And this is Above the Noise, the show that cuts through the hype.
And digs into the science, wait.
You almost had it.
And digs into the science behind the headlines.
So, you know, as you can tell, Shireen's not here. She's across the pond in Europe somewhere. And I don't like to be lonely. So I thought it'd be cool if we got the producer of this episode to come in and kind of help us out. So here we have Lauren Farrar.
That's me.
Welcome.
Hi.
Thanks for coming by, even though you work here. Wasn't that hard to find you. So first off, I wanted to jump into, you know, we got to recap the episode. Duh. So last episode was about 4 tips to help you spot bad science reporting. And we've even come up with this nifty little acronym to help you remember. GLAD, G-L-A-D. G, get past the clickbait. L, look for crazy claims. A, analyze sources. And D, determine opinions of outside experts. Just sit back, relax, and be glad. GLAD.
So glad.
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 So first off, let's jump into a comment that I thought was just really hard hitting. Something that really just touched me and just like, you know, it just hit real hard.
Yeah.
So from Tyrese, he writes in and says, this guy's pretty funny. Me? Moi? Thanks, Tyrese. I really appreciate that. Don't you agree?
Yeah. Thank you for sharing that comment. Real important there, Myles. Real important.
Nah, man. Tyrese is just the homie. You know, I didn't have to pay him to say that, but I'm glad he did because it helps my ego. But more hard-pressing comments. Let's go into...
What do you got? What do you got?
What do I got for you? Where is it? Oh, Gabriel writes in and says, what's the difference between fake news and a misleading headline?
Ah, well, Gabriel, that's a really good question. So fake news, I think, generally just refers to news that's based on absolutely nothing, like based on a lie or like not founded in any sort of reality. That's probably fake news.
Probably.
Probably. Whereas like a misleading headline is probably based on something real, but the headline just kind of makes it a little bit more sensationalized or a little bit exaggerated.
So like clickbait, basically.
Yeah.
Something to make you want to read it, hopefully.
Exactly, right.
But the problem comes in when people don't read the article and just read the headline.
Get past the clickbait. Read the article.
And another thing that it kind of brings up is, you know, people really do believe this stuff. I mean, on the far end of the spectrum, I remember when, you know, Pizzagate happened and, you know, the child pornography ring that was happening in the basement of the pizza shop. And, you know, casual viewers will kind of scroll past that. But, you know, there was a guy that went there with his gun drawn thinking that he was going to save children. So I think it's really important that we kind of, you know, take a step back and actually like apply these rules. Like you have to really be critical of this information that you're taking in.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, and I mean, and it's not, I mean, that's a super extreme case, but like in everyday life, like we need to be able to understand the science behind a lot of things because it affects, you know, decisions that we make affect our environment, they affect our health, and they have all these far, you know, reaching implications. You really need to understand science.
Next comment comes from CMZ Unicorn. I think that's a cool name. I get stuck on the name, I'm sorry. How does a source become credible?
CMZ Unicorn, good question. So when you're reading any sort of science reporting, I think a really good thing to look for are things like, well, what is this based on? Who did they talk to or interview in that article? You wanna make sure that it's a scientist that's actually a credible source, right? Somebody who is working as a scientist who has the degrees and is qualified to talk about the topic.
Yeah, that was something I was really curious about because it's like, you know, I'm starting out as a journalist and I've kind of been doing it on and off, but it's like, that's social justice, that's, you know, going on man on the street almost and kind of just talking to people. And I was always kind of curious, like, well, how does it work for science when it comes to things that, you know, well, it has to be true, obviously, but like when it comes to things that are a little more technical. So that's kind of, you know, very helpful. And that kind of goes into the next comment, actually, from a Eunice Jungs, who says, not all academic journals are accessible for the common person. So how do you feel about that?
Well, that is true. The academic journals are definitely written for an academic audience. And so sort of science journalist, their job is to take all that technical stuff and translate it so that everybody can understand it. And it's a really, it's a big challenge. It's a balancing act between making something accessible and staying true to the science and not overhyping stuff.
How do you kind of like tackle that accessibility versus, you know?
Yeah, I mean, that's what drew me to Above the Noise. Like, I get to take these complex topics and really sort of distill them into like the core and meat and make it accessible.
Hmm. We're glad. This is tight. I like this. Because it's like a, you know, almost like an inside the actor studio with the producer. So I want to thank you for coming from behind the camera to in front of the camera to sit with us and, you know, take our comments and answer all these questions. And remember, if you guys have any comments, any ideas for future episodes, put them in that comment section below and we'll read them and do our best to answer them. And remember, this is Above the Noise, a show that cuts through the hype
and takes you above the noise.
Yeah, perfect.
Woo! Thanks, guys.
Thank you.